Madame Kasamkono. Mwe bali kumpuliza kuwa katona nasia.
Together with the health experts, and we now introduce new measures. Given the complication of trying to control those people who are coming from the heavily affected countries, we decided that we stop completely all passengers coming into Uganda or moving out of Uganda. It is better we save the base, which is Uganda, with the 42 million people who are here. Yes, there are Ugandans who are outside, but like when we were fighting the war, if the camp was attacked, the first priority was to defeat the attack on their camp. If you had gone out to buy food, to do what, you stay where you are. You cannot come in the middle of the fighting. The fight, where would you pass? You will be killed. And we cannot stop fire and say, oh, let allow the one who had gone to buy food to come back. Because where will he pass? So that's why we said no more passengers coming into Uganda or going out, either by land or by air or by water. The only people who can come in are the drivers and tannboys of vehicles which are carrying cargo. I bet say migugu. The good thing with those is that they are few, they are not many. We said only three per vehicle, not more than three. The driver, the tannboy, maybe one other person. The same with the cargo planes. The good thing is that we need the cargo, of course. The country needs the cargo. And even to take out our own cargo, which is going out. But that's not the main point. It's not the economics. It is also the ease of monitoring the three people per vehicle. Compared to these thousands of passengers. So we announced that measure yesterday, and we also said we shall not allow people to come in by either walking or cycling. All those will not be allowed. Through the gazetted centers and even the hidden ones, we are going to deploy the forces on all those. They mentioned them. I think they're 103 and another one 50 something. They have all the details. Now, as we were in the meeting yesterday, the religious meeting, and then afterwards the strategic committee meeting about this health issue and the broadcast which I was making. Now, when we got out, apparently there is a Ugandan young man, 36 years old, who had left for Dubai on the 17th of March. He came back morning of 21st, which was yesterday. And to the credit of our health teams, you know, they have been waiting at that airport. Whenever I pass there on the VIP side, I see them. And the other day when I was in Mbare, I saw them there. Now, when this gentleman came back, the machine, the temperature monitor, was able to see that his temperature was 38.7 degrees centigrade. The normal temperature? The normal temperature is 37.5 or below. So these people put him aside, said, this is a bit high. Put him aside, and after 30 minutes, brought him back. Because those are their procedures. They are rombo-rombo. Then it was the temperature was still high. So, and he told them that he had a fever, but he was not coughing, and he was not okwetsiamura. You know, I told you the other day that English language is very poor. They don't have enough words because they say sneezing. So sneezing in Nyankole that doesn't make sense, because when I sneeze in, that is okshoreza. Okshoreza. In fact, children are normally beaten. Don't okshoreza. Don't, because it is taken as a bad habit. Children who are fond of sucking in the air in their nose. It's called okshoreza. Now, in English, you don't have that. I think they call that sneezing. Now, when you question, when you have a cold, you blow out. They call that sneezing also. So please, I think because you are English people, you are English speakers, you people, I will now introduce a new word for you to say sneezing out, meaning your question, because you don't have it in your English language, and sneezing in, meaning your kshoreza, because you don't have it in your English language. So I have introduced a new word for you, sneezing out or sneezing in. But the problem here is sneezing out. It is okwetsiamura. The problem is okwetsiamura and okukorora, coughing. They are the danger here. So this person was not sneezing out, was not coughing, but he had a fever. He himself felt a fever, although he didn't, of course, tell anybody. It was only after he was put aside that he he was detected by your system. I must congratulate you people. Your system detected this fellow through the temperature monitoring and put him aside and did him again. They confirmed temperature, then they took him now to the hospital where they took the blood, and by yesterday afternoon apparently the blood had confirmed that he was positive for corona. Now remember, he had been to Dubai since 17th. Now the question is, did he go with this disease? Which means we trace where he was coming from. And the health people have already contacted all his family people. They have told me about his family people. They already know them. And they have checked all of them. it seems there is nobody who is complaining of any sickness among that cluster of the people associated with this young man. So there's a strong likelihood that he picked it in Dubai, although they have not yet ruled the other one out completely. And that can be possible because they say when you get it, the symptoms can develop in 2 days or later, but within 14 days. But they say that some even remain what they call asymptomatic for longer. I'm also beginning to hear that. Uh-huh. But what I would like my experts here who are sitting here to explain to you is if he's asymptomatic, if he's not coughing, if he's not sneezing, if you are not shaking hands, because you remember I told you shaking hands, they say you are dying to shake hands. I don't know why you are dying to shake hands. Dying to shake hands. And if they don't shake hands, they hit elbows. I don't want anybody to hit me with the elbow. Elbow for what? These are idiotic things. Bible gamba, tibale kanga biwa sande kukola. Nibakola biwa ta sande kukola. Namaz matugari mubo. Mukole, elbow. I don't want that nonsense. For what? I have seen you, I have greeted you. Finish. What else do you want from me? That you want my elbow to box you? Mambo ya chijinga tu. So, no shaking of hands. I told you this long, long ago. The other day when the Archbishop of Canterbury was here, I said, please. Thank you very much. I see you. I wave to you. You know that I like you very much. But in the book of Genesis, God commanded us to establish dominion over nature. And this is one of establishing dominion over this virus. Don't touch it. Why do you touch it? So, what I want these people to explain to you later on, if this fellow remains asymptomatic, does he infect people? They will explain to you later. So, you can see the wisdom of what we did to close these schools and stop the church meetings and stop the mosques and stop the political rallies, all those measures which were announced on the 18th. Now, where we are, the only remaining danger is public transport. That is the only remaining danger. Because this public transport is where you get these people who are sitting together in a bus or a minibus or a taxi. This is the one I am struggling with in my head, how to handle. Therefore, for now, I appeal to you, if you don't have your own private transport, your own car, or your own motorcycle, or your own bicycle, don't use this public transport. Stay at home. Where are you going? Before I came here, I was watching UBC. There is a confused young man, a doctor, Obuku. You remember the other Obuku boy who was making a lot of nonsense. I think Corona also makes people sensible. I saw the man talking sense for the first time. This Obuku man. I saw him saying, just like I'm telling you, please stay at home, postpone that business, it can wait. I said, Banang, Obuku is reasonable. So corona should not be underestimated. I think it can also make people are not reasonable. So the question is, you stay home. If you don't have your own transport, stay home. Meanwhile, I appeal to the managers of those groups, the buses. I have not banned them yet, but I'm appealing to you to minimize the use of those public transport means. But also for the owners of those vehicles, of those systems, to not allow anybody who has got a flu or coughing on a public means of transport. Secondly, to arrange for people to have these temperature monitors. To arrange to have them temperature monitored at some of these embarkation and disembarkation points, the bus parks and so on. I don't know whether the Minister of Health can manage to cope with that because the demand may be too much. Thirdly, for people to wash their hands with the disinfectants when they are entering and when they are leaving. But you, at the individual level, if you don't have to, please don't use those public transport means. Because this is the only remaining danger which I see, the possible weak point. Now, for the students and school children who went home, stay home. The other night I saw my senior presidential advisor on epidemics, Dr. Musenero, who is sitting here, advising you young people to stay in your homes. Don't go to the trading centers. You are in your home. You are in Rakitura, don't go to Rusheri, to Loita, in the town. Don't go to the Antonde, don't go to Masaka. You just stay in your father's home, your parents' home, where there's less crowding. These are people who know one another. They are strangers. They are no strangers. You are safe there. Stay home. Stop loitering in towns. But that can also be another area which nullifies our efforts. We save you from here, you go, instead you go to Loita in Kaveramaido town or Kalaki or those Chichibuku and all those places, the trading centers. Home means home, a car. Mbere our car. Gang, being a gang in the home. Pacho. That's what we are saying. We are not sending you from the town, from the school to the trading center. That's not the address we sent you. And last night I was telling you how our people survived the smallpox of 1893. At that time there was no vaccine for the smallpox, no vaccine for. People survived by just behavior. Instead of staying in the royal kraal at Mbarara there, where many people died, they went to the villages. That's how they survived. And the epidemic passes after some time. It went away. Because, like smallpox, either it kills you, I don't know within how many days, or you survive it, and then it goes. It kills some and others survive. So either way, its time runs out. So if you isolate the ones who are infected until they either die or survive, then it will end there. I don't think it remains in the ground or what. That's smallpox of 1891. In fact, the Banyankole call it Umzegwa Muti, the smallpox of Muti. That was the old name of Mbarara, because it is the Mbarara people who died most. The ones who were in the royal kraal, the Orembo, the palace of the king. Yeah. Then nightclubs and bars. Nightclubs and bars are not workplaces. Because you remember I told you that the workplaces should remain open. The workplaces are factories, and hotels, and offices. These are the workplaces. The advantage of the workplaces is that the people who come there are known. There is a known number of the workers who work in a factory. So you can know who is sick, and you say, no, you have a cough, stay at home, and you also check him. And the others come. But the problem with nightclubs and with bars, they are ad hoc. Anybody comes, that's where the danger is. The one you know and the one you don't know, they all come. So that's why they are dangerous. You cannot regulate them. You cannot regulate them. That's why they should therefore be closed. Nobody should say that a bar or a nightclub falls in the definition of a workplace. Because it is very difficult to know who is who. But above all, my view is that this virus is actually very easy to defeat. When I listen to the experts and they are here, they can repeat. When I listen carefully, because that's how I fought AIDS. The experts told me what they knew. And out of what they told me, we designed a strategy, which was the ABC, abstinence, be faithful, use the condom. That's how we defeated AIDS, even before the medicine came, these drugs which people are using now. We brought down the prevalence of AIDS from 18% national to 6%. Even before the ARVs. Actually, when the ARVs came, that's when it went up again to 7%, but I think now it has come down again. And we did this just by preaching, like I'm preaching it to you now. by telling the people how the virus was behaving and how we could avoid it. The same with Ebola. That's what we did with Ebola. So even this one, when I listened carefully, it is actually easier to defeat if we are serious. How? Because it spreads apparently by two methods. Method number one, okwetyamura, sneezing out, and coughing, or cholera, near other people, within the distance of how many meters?
About 3 meters.
Hmm?
Up to 3 meters.
Within the distance of 3 meters. You sneeze out or you cough out, you cough 3 meters from me and you are infected and I'm not infected, you put me in danger. This is way number one. So the answer for this is that anybody with a cold, don't go into a public. Yeah. Stay at home and then be managed there. Please, coughing out, sneezing out, coughing, stay at home. Of course, at home you should also isolate yourself. Don't infect your children or your siblings. Isolate yourself and call in the medical people to come and check you. Because these people have a few testing places, but during the Ebola time, they had worked out, or Musenro can tell you what they were doing, how they used to bring samples from I don't know where, and then they check them and they go back. So if we handle the coughing and the sneezing, and just restrict it, these experts will tell me about the asymptomatic, the other ones who are not coughing, who are not sneezing. Like this young man who is in Entebbe now. Because he was not sneezing, he was not coughing, but he had temperature. And Acheng told me that this morning he had like red eyes or something like that. Uh-huh. Which is another sign, but not yet coughing, not what. So this is number one. Everybody needs to do this. Let's ensure that nobody who is coughing, who is sneezing out, because you don't have the word. I cannot say kwetiamra. You cannot follow it. You speak English, but English is poor. So I have now got a word for you, sneezing out and coughing. Please, stay at home. Now, second one is okwefuka. The English don't have a word for that, okwefuka. They call it blowing your nose, that you blow your nose. But when you call it okwefuka, when you okwefuka, you blow your nose, and somehow the mucus goes through the hand, the whatever you are using, handkerchief, whatever, and the virus goes onto your hands, and then you touch surfaces. Touching surfaces, tables, chairs, door handles, car doors. Now, this virus stayed there for?
Up to 3 days.
Yeah. Say therefore, correct information. Plastic.
Yes, plastic surfaces have shown the longest time.
Which is?
Up to 9 days. They have been able to detect the virus up to 9 days on plastic surfaces.
So, you hear that in some surfaces, the plastic ones, the virus can stay there for 9 days. So that's why it may be good to periodically disinfect these common user surfaces, like the tables in offices, these conference tables where the big men and women are talking, and sweating. Does anybody go through sweating? The virus. It's not known, but touching. So periodically, like after every 6 hours or something, you could, in these offices, government offices, you could have some people going around with the disinfectants and cleaning the door handles, the tables. But at a personal level, what I would like these experts to either refute or confirm, even if this chair is contaminated and I also touch it and the virus goes on my hands, but I don't touch myself, I don't touch my eyes, especially my eyes. My eyes, my mouth, my nose. From what I've been told, the virus will not enter you. It will stay on your hands until you wash with soap and it goes away. So for me, Banang is the Dava, this virus is easy to defeat. If we are, like, you follow my NRA way, because NRA, National Resistance Army, was a people's war. Not a war of experts, not a war of professionals, it was a war of the people. Yeah. So I am here to lead a people's war, if you want me to lead you. I led the villagers to defeat the soldiers of the barracks, the soldiers of the salaries. We, the Nigerians, were able to study the science of war, master it, and use it to defeat the professionals. So they were Nang, they end up being Mwebio. Or cholera. Ukwesi amrumu gani bokuweta? Huh? Ukwefuka. So, ekizibu ekiri wano. Biri bintu bisatu. Tewali kyakuna bisatu byokka okwesamula eri abantu abangi ogumuganda yamba yanjye okwasimula otyo okwasimula eri abantu abangi okukorora eri abantu abangi okwata awali ya kawuka niwe kwata ko niwe kwata mbitundu ebisatu enyindo bageta chimurugana aha enyindo amaso omukamwa omunda. So these are the two issues. Three, actually. Okwe chambra, okora, okwe kwataho. Because even if the surfaces were contaminated and you touched them, but you did not touch yourself, in the delicate parts, the three parts, the virus will not enter you. Unless there's new science, somebody was talking of Orofico, that somebody had detected going through feces. Have you heard of that? Your comment on that? Okay, your comment on that. Nwechi wanange, biyange, biyebio. Nzewa nukule mbirucharo, uruwaba mwana inchi, ukweru anako. Ngabo twakola okulwanyisa abatemu abali batemula abantu, okulwanyisa sirimu, okulwanyisa Ebola, okulwanyisa olunkusense olwatanga abaana, okulwanyisa polio, ebyo byonna twabirwanyisa tuyita mu kukunga abantu okubanyonyola kati kyendiko kikindese wano ku Sande okubanjirira wetutuse n'okubagamba nti olucalo tusobola okuluwangula singa tukola birya ebisatu. Naye kati bano bongedde ekyokuna ekyokugenda mu kabuyonjo n'otanaaba obulungi n'okwata emmere ekyo nakyo bakyongeddeko banakinyonyola bulungi. Thank you very much. I wish you good luck. I wish you God's protection. Can we get comments from you people, Minister?
Thank you very much, Excellency, for updating the public again following.